Time now for Original Riders Part 3, which will take place here in Detroit. And you know what? I'm going to replace my star vinyl here with something else, because I figure since it's now been long enough, yeah, I'll go with this one. And I'll change the color to... I'll make it custom. And... well, I need this to be visible, so... Yeah. Sure, whatever. Why not? I'm not really changing anything else on this thing. Okay, let's go and do our final set of races with the original riders.
What'd I tell you? You was racing a fool.
As my first race is right down here. And I am gonna head down there now. Because I figure... oh, and Roy is back on the map again. I'm going to assume that must be for the US Championship Series now. However, I need to get through doing the rest of these first, as we have just 4 races to go. As we start off with Hockey Town. I'd assume when they say that they refer to an ice hockey stadium, but I don't know for sure. Anyway, here we go. Hopefully this will not be quite as hard as what I had with the Jambala I just drove. And I just jinxed myself. It really feels like at the moment I'm basically just sinking in quicksand. And it just feels like the whole thing is just not going to work, regardless of how hard I try to make it work. It literally just doesn't matter what I do. The whole thing is just not going to work. Unless I can somehow stay out of trouble long enough for me to be doing a bit more than just swinging for the fences and hitting them. Which at this stage, it feels like I'm precisely what I have been doing at the moment. Because I've been swinging for the fences and I've been going straight into those fences. Like the whole thing is just becoming very obvious now that regardless of how hard I try to avoid it in most areas, the game always has to find a way to retaliate. Which at this stage is becoming more obvious to me now than it ever has been before, basically. As in, the whole thing just seems like it wants to just swing straight for me and hit me. Regardless of how hard I really try to avoid it. This might be my best shot. to actually get it done. And I do get it done, surprisingly. I really thought for sure that was going to be a heart-wrenching loss. But I somehow beat Maddie to the line. And that only took me 13 minutes to get there. So Fernando was 3rd, Dwayne 4th, Tracy 5th, Kayla 6th, and AJ 7th.
Now that's a real bike!
Oscar, I would honestly be amazed if the Ducati SS1000 was not considered a real bike. Yeah, we've now got level 2 performance parts. Cool. Unfortunately, I won't be able to fit those on my Jambala as much as I really wanted to, but whatever. Clearing race 1 after 13 minutes, and now we have to weave our way through race number 2 here in Detroit. I will get on with the Bad Boys tournament at some point. We have got some Kawasakis in the field. Let's see how we go. I really need to make sure I don't go straight for the fences here, which could take a little while. I'm not really in a very good place right now, in terms of my overall pace at this stage. As a matter of fact, it feels like the whole thing is just basically making me waste away in my sweat and rust. And I feel like the only way for me to actually correct some of these errors is just to use zone through a few of these corners. And make it so the whole thing does manage to somehow piece itself back together again. I was off the throttle for too long. At least I actually managed to stay on my bike that time, which is one good thing I get out of this. Yeah, I had to use zone because if I didn't, then that would have been catastrophe. Unless I can somehow pull this off. And I do somehow pull it off. I was not expecting that to happen on only my 3rd attempt, as Boo finished in 2nd and Ivana was 3rd. Brick's 4th, Dwayne finishes 5th, and weren't there 6 of us in this race? And it was Doobs who finished in 6th. Oh, there were 7 of us. Okay. Dwayne 5th, Dubs in 6th, and E-Dub finished in 7th.
Yeah, homie, I'm impressed.
I'm now up to 210 grand, which means I probably have enough to buy myself another car. Anyway, let's get my replay, since I figured that's what I should do whilst I'm here. Because getting the replay is the next best thing I can do. I'll restart and make sure that I turn the text off. You know, it's an interesting case when it comes to riding the sport bikes, because you feel like you're prone to other people's errors, but then once you eventually figure out how to overcome the cracks in the wall, eventually you do manage to see yourself putting together an effective way of making sure that your run is good. Well, the reason I'm still using Naomi is because, well, I used Naomi for the first two parts, and I figured, well, since this is technically a pink bike, and also because, well, I like how she has a pink outfit, I might as well just keep the theme going until I'm finished with this. And believe me, I will be finished with this soon enough. But anyway, I still have a lot more club racing to get through before we can go to the end. Which I think is one thing that no doubt deserves a mention. But nonetheless, I have managed to make sure that I'm somehow moving forwards, and at the end of the day, I'd say I'm moving forwards pretty well. With my pink Ducati SS1000, and also with me riding this bike as Naomi, I'd say the whole thing has gone pretty well altogether. Anyway, two races down, two races to go, as our next one is called Hall. And once again, it is a circuit race, which means the last one is either going to be an ordered race or an unordered race. I can't wait to see what happens. But anyway, here we go. Time now for the penultimate original riders race in this game, as we have just one to go after this one, and then after that another set of club races will be done, providing I can manage to stay out of trouble long enough, of course, which I think is the biggest question. And I don't. That does not surprise me. I should probably restart this once I'm done. If I fall too far back, then I'll basically restart this. Luckily, however, I have not fallen too far back, which is one thing. Plus, I do have a pretty fast bike as well, which means I am technically still in this one. I technically still have a fighting chance. And I am right behind the leader, because of how fast my bike is. Which in all honesty surprises even me, because I did not think I was going to be quite this fast. I thought it might be possible for me to overcome the deficit, but not like this. At least not this early on anyway. I guess it must be because my bike is that much faster than everyone else. That's probably what the case is at this stage of the event, for now. I'm just hoping I can keep it in that position. Which at the moment hasn't exactly been at my absolute best. I also think Zone will no doubt help me out of a few. Gaping holes. Okay, so I know I need to go straight here. And on the brakes, making sure I don't miss the corner, which I think is a good thing, because it means I might have a fighting chance this time. If possible. Although I reckon zone is still going to be needed through certain corners. Just to keep me out of trouble long enough. Which at the moment, I'm not doing too badly with. I thought for sure I was going to be doing worse than this, but thankfully, at this stage at least, we seem to be doing well, because I have not failed spectacularly yet. And I'm wondering how long it's going to be before I do fail spectacularly. If that does happen. But anyway. Shifting up into 6th, through the final corner, keeping a hold of my bike, and through the road, and I surprisingly won that race first try. Over Drywall, T-Bone, Dupes, and Boo. Where is the 6th placed car, I wonder? I will give him or her about probably 30 seconds. Oh, there he is. And it was Ivana who finished in 6th.
That's my homie!
Alright. One race to go. And then we have beaten the original riders. This has been a lot less stressful psychologically for me to work my way through. I can certainly say that for sure, compared to what I was up against last time. I can certainly guarantee my money will not be short after this. Because I am well in excess of possessing over $200,000. And I'm pretty sure if I keep this up, then I will not be too far away from purchasing a... Oh god, okay. It's okay, it's fine. We're still fine. I am managing to dodge the bullets pretty well for now. It would really help if the AI could just stop swinging straight for the traffic, because then maybe, if it's possible, my experience here would be just a little bit more forgiving, knowing that I do actually have the odds of avoiding the AI and their messes right before I go straight into my own messes. Which, as you might have guessed at this stage, is a lot harder than it looks. But at least I'm trying. And that, I suppose, is the one thing I have been known to do at this stage. Some things seem to be working better for me than others. But it is. But nonetheless, doesn't matter. I put together a run that was mistake-free, and I surprisingly stayed out of trouble with the traffic this time. So, 6/10 of a second is the margin of victory over Drywall. Boo finishes 3rd, Xavier 4th, Dupes in 5th, and Dwayne finishes in 6th.
Maybe Oscar was right. Maybe you ain't just a punk.
Vince, I will take that as a compliment. Considering you literally said, maybe I am more than just a punk, and wow. We have unlocked the Kawasaki Ninja ZX 12R from winning this. Holy fucking crap, that is a bike. That is most definitely a bike worth winning. I can certainly say that for sure. Did I record a replay? Oh yeah, I recorded the second race. Yeah, I did get a replay. Anyway, let's get our shine on, brothers.
Hey Holmes, everybody loves a Kawasaki Ninja. If you got the guts to ride one, that is.
Hey Oscar, you know who does have the guts to ride a Kawasaki Ninja? Tom Cruise. Because he is basically the guy that made the Kawasaki Ninja famous after that runway scene from Top Gun. Anyway, another set of club races is done, and we have now reached 75% completion in terms of the main career mode. And I guess what we'll do next is we'll finish off the Chopper of America Bike Club. I think that's probably what we'll do next. So we're now 75% complete, and now I'm going to head back to the garage and show you my new bike. I will probably also be using this bike for when we get to Tokyo. But anyway, let's see if I can find it. Here it is. The Kawasaki Ninja ZX 12R. And by God, is this thing a bike? This is most well and truly a bike. I can also certainly tell you the guys who race at the Isle of Man certainly have the guts to ride a Kawasaki Ninja. Even then, if to the eyes of most people, those Isle of Man TT riders technically have a screw loose. But whatever, it doesn't matter. So, Kawasaki Ninja ZX 12R. I am so glad I won this bike. And I think what I'll do now is I want to switch back to my Clevito now, if I can find it. Here it is. So switching back to the Hot Match Clevito. And do I have the level 2 upgrades on this thing? Yes I do. Okay. So, all of the original riders, racers have now been cleared. And next time, we will be finishing off the Chopper of America Bike Club. So, coming up next in Midnight Club 3, part 3 in the Chopper of America Bike Club.